Billy Elliot first hit the big screen in 2000, would you believe? The story of a young boy trading his boxing gloves for ballet pumps and his struggle to make his dancing dreams come true stole the nation's heart. The musical premiered in the West End in 2005, and in the last 9 years, it's won over 80 theatre awards globally and has now been seen by an incredible 9.5 million people worldwide. It's easy to see why it's been such a success.
It doesn't matter if you're large or small, trapezoid, short or tall. Even if you can dance at all, all you really have to do is shine.
Solidarity, solidarity, solidarity forever. Very proud to be working class.
Please welcome Ruthie Henshaw. Ruthie, if ever there was a show with heart, this is it, isn't it?
That is it.
I mean, does it do to you every night what it does to us as an audience going in there? I was blown away by it. I saw it a good few years ago now, and it's such an enormously feel-good thing to watch.
It's amazing. I still watch anything that I'm not in. I stand in the wings and watch it, especially when it involves the boys, because they are so talented. But it still makes me cry.
Oh, well, it's such a strong story. You are, you're welling up now thinking about it. That's nice.
I'm so proud to be in it, because it is such a phenomenal show. And 9 years later, because we did the Billy Live, 9 years later, the creative team came back, and you know, to actually have them hands on again 9 years after.
Now, tell us about this. It was beamed to cinemas, wasn't it? All across the land.
Yes.
And you brought back a lot of the original Billies, who are probably now about 46.
You know, they ranged from, I think it was about 24 down to 9, or no, 10, I think the youngest is. And they did what they called a mash-up, and they got all these Billies back, 27 of them, and they did the most amazing, what they called a mash-up. They, I mean, what these boys are doing now as well, it changed their lives, you know, going into the show anyway. But what they've gone on to do is incredible.
Well, we had members of the Royal Ballet on a couple of weeks ago, and they were saying now at the Royal Ballet School, it's absolutely even now, 50% boys, 50% girls.
It's brought it up that high.
Down in huge terms to Billy Elliot, isn't it?
Yes, but one of the boys was saying, not the young boy, one of the lads who's a bit older, I asked him if he thought that, you know, it was still a little bit of a boys don't do ballet attitude still around. He said, I think it depends where you live.
Yeah.
He said, I come from Essex and I never told anybody that I was going to ballet.
So it depends where you are. How many boys have you got?
We've got four at the moment. Yeah. We've got one in training and we've got another one who's going to start training. So they've got a constant, you know, because they have to have four. Because if you think about it, they can only do two or three shows a week. It is, I mean, astounding what they have to do.
And how long is the life of a Billy in Billy Elliot? How long can he carry on for doing the role?
Until his voice breaks or he gets too tall.
Yeah.
I mean, we had a Michael who left recently because he literally couldn't sing the songs anymore. It was quite sweet to watch, actually.
Oh, but, it's real life.
It's real life. And but I think after a couple of years, they want to go out there and play football again. Yeah. You know, they want to, because they can't play football. Yeah. They can't do those kind of things. They live in a house together with the Debbies, the Michaels and the Billies. And their life becomes about Billy Elliot. You know, they're doing school in the morning. They're doing either rehearsals or class in the afternoon, or they're doing rehearsals, class or the show in the evening.
Gosh, apart from anything else, it must be exhausting.
I think so. I mean, I think that they earn their money. I don't know what they earn, but I think they earn it.
You are hugely experienced in terms of musical theatre, everything from Marguerite to Billy Elliot to goodness knows what you've done, Broadway and this country. The difference between Broadway and the West End in terms of performance, audience, is there one?
Yes, big difference.
In what way?
The audiences are different. And I think it's a cultural thing. American audiences are far louder. They tend to sort of really vocally get involved. Whereas we as English people, you know, we think It's jolly good, isn't it? You don't want to disturb the personal stage. I don't know what it is, but it's just a cultural thing, I think.
But standing ovations are becoming more frequent in this country than they ever used to be. I mean, I don't remember growing up in my 20s and 30s, not ever being part of a standing ovation. Now it happens a lot. I mean, I went to Matilda last week and justified it, quite right too. Stunning show. And people were up at the end. And if one row stands up, you've got to stand up, you don't see anything. So, are standing ovations more frequent now than they were?
I honestly think it depends on the show.
Yeah. Do you get them in Billy Elliot?
Every single night, I kid you not. That's why it's such a joy to be a part of, because these kids are...
Well, that's it.
The it's life watching, and soul.
Yeah. It was the same with Matilda, watching children on stage who are good, who are dedicated, who are focused. Yes. It's like handing on the baton for you, I guess, as an actress, isn't it? You know, seeing
it's incredible. And what's lovely, I mean, I've got a dresser who's been there for 10 years dressing the Mrs. Wilkinson. And she kind of gave me the lowdown on the first day, because I put on these particular trousers and I said, I can't bear these trousers. By the way, my costumes, I owned every single one of them back in the 80s. I'm literally dressed in my old clothes.
Yeah.
But I put on these trousers and I said, these are horrible. She said, it's all right, darling, they're not looking at you, they're looking at the kid. And she was quite... I looked at her and she went, no, really, they're looking at the kid. And it's Billy's show, you know, but that's what is so fantastic about being in it.
Is it to be a part of it?
It is.
Billy Elliot at the Victoria Palace Theatre. And the DVD goes on sale in that special performance on the 24th of November. My thanks for now to Ruthie Henschel. Thank you, Ruthie.
Thank you.